So thank you very much for the invitation to give a talk here. I'm so amazed by the quality of all the speakers that are up to now. So the title of the talk is from Fig et al. Fig and Mahmoudul over to representations. G. So G will be an irreductible group, but you can suppose it GLN, for instance. The story starts by Colmes. So Colmes gave a functor, gave a map starting from V, going to pi of V, and here this is a Galois representation. Which is of dimension 2 over an extension of 2p that is finite, which is irreducible. And of course, continuous. And here it is a Banner space over L. That is with a unitary reaction of GL2K. And it is also admissible. It is also irreducible. And Pascunas describes the image of the map, and he proves it is a bijection between this side and this side when P is at least 5. So this will be the second talk. People will speak of that. I will not speak of that. So now my talk is about if to replace 2 and 2 here by D. So I will just explain to you what is the proof of Colmes, and I will try to generalize it. So all this work is in progress. It's almost finished, but it's work in progress. The hardest parts are still to be done. Work in progress with Peter Schneider. And I hope that you will understand the proof of Colmes after my talk. So we'll see. Anyway, so what is the first step? Step one. So Fontaine, it is a Fontaine equivalence of a category. So one, if you take any d-dimensional continuous representation of the Galois group. Over L, the ring of integer of L, you replace it. It's an equivalent of a category. You can replace it by what is called the phi gamma module. Over. This notation is a notation of Colmes that still used, or it may be of Fontaine, I don't know, which is a very well-known ring. And in the n in R, and goes to 0 when n goes to minus infinity. And it has to be etal. And if it is free of dimension d, free of dimension d, so this will be of dimension d. And if you want to work over L, you tensor by L, and the equivalence works as well. And you can also reduce it, and it works as well. So here, D is NA. That doesn't have to be 2. Step 1. Step 2. So Kelmes will look at this part. So we forgot about Galois representation, and now we are working with etal phi gamma module. Step 2, so one can look at this etal module as an etal representation of a monoid. Which monoid? So this is a monoid, that p minus 0. So here, P1 corresponds to the action of phi. Zp star corresponds to the action of gamma. And the 1 Zp1 corresponds to the action of OL of t. So, okay. This is a monoid inside of GL2. Well, it's kind of silly because we're working with dimension D. But still, you can do that. And then Kelmes had a character of QP star. And so that, and he decides that in GL2 QP, you have the center. So you multiply this monoid by the center. And it decides that the center will act by this character. So in some sense, it replaces this monoid by another monoid that I will call here P plus. So there is phi gamma. There is this, I will call it N0. And you can write this monoid like N0. T plus, where T plus are the diagonal matrices on this. So this was the second step that we'll try to generalize to something more general than GL2. Now, so step 3. Then this etal module, I call them D. So starting with D sigma, delta, Kelmes constructs a representation that he writes, he denotes by D delta P1, which is a representation GL2. And then he writes, cette représentation n'a aucune raison d'avoir de bonnes propriétés en général. So I am sorry because it's easy that I'm going to generalize. But we have the step 4. Maybe can I erase that? And I don't speak of the step 4. I don't. Step 4. He said, but if D, the dimension D is equal to 2, if V is D is irreducible, and if delta is the character of V, you start with the V representation of Galois, you have the determinant of delta of V, but local classical theory gives you a character of QP star. And you multiply it, I write it like that, determinant of V, and you multiply it by the inverse of the cyclotomic character, then this representation is interesting because looking at a trianguline, I don't know, case, line. So he put this in an exact sequence. So this is it. Correspond to V. And here, I don't know what is here. This is a dual tensor by this character. And this is the pi of V, which is the image of V by the local Langlands correspondent for GL to QP. What is what here? Some dual tensor by delta D.
Ah, donc. What, pi of V?
Pi of D, yes. Okay. This will be pi of V. Okay, so I am going to explain to you the step three in a general situation. So, general situation, take in G, any reductive group over QP. But we think of GL, D, QP should be very fine. Take inside P, which will be the triangular subgroup, the Borel subgroup, write it NT, with N as the nilpotent thing, and T is the maximal torus. You can suppose the split is not necessary, but you can put it. Inside of this, you have the N0, which is a compact open subgroup. And you look at T plus, which is a set of elements in T that normalize this. And you have the monoid P plus. Okay. And you take the element which is correspond to phi. For instance, you call it S or phi, correspond to the phi. For GLD QP, it will be P to the D minus 1, P D minus 2, P. Excuse me, Comté d'une zéro. Okay. And I take A, which is now just a commutative ring. And I will decompose the proof and the construction of Clomers in different steps. And the steps are this one. You start with a module over A with an ethal action of P plus. So ethal module. And then I will say things about this. And then you go to an ethal, to a representation of P, but I'll call this an AP module. Step B. And then that I will denote M to the P. And then I go to something that I will denote MPBD, the something. And this is the same thing. I call this part C. And this is the same thing that an AG module. That I denote M BD. And at the end, I will just explain how you can go by some Ethal figure module. Or epsilon to something like that, with some good choice of. So this is the scheme of, now we start. So let us look at A. A, well, you start with an Ethal AP plus module.
I'm sorry, can you say, can you explain what this is?
Yes, I will.
Sorry.
I am organizing my talk.
Okay.
I am going to tell you this at the end.
Okay.
I will replace it immediately by something else. Okay? So the first result is that an Ethal module is canonically the space of the of sections of a PP ground sheaf on N0. So what is the action? You have an action of P on N, and the action is the following. If you take an element in NT, and an element x in n, this is in nt, so the action is goes to n t x t minus 1. So this belongs to n. So, and you can look at t plus or p plus is a p stabilizer of n0. So this is the first step. Of the proof of calmness. So I am not going to tell you now what is an Ethal AP module, but I'm going to tell you what a sheaf on N0 is. So what is it? This means that M has a structure. M is an A of P plus module as a structure of module on the skew monoid ring, which is a function that are locally constant on N0 with value in A. And I don't know how one calls this in English, not in French neither, in fact, which is this ring, P locally constant function here, for P in P plus. And if you take an element P here, you want to how do you permute that? You say that this is equal to this, where FP of X is equal to f of px. So the equivalent of a category of this module, there is a unit, it's a ring, there is a unit, the module should be unital. And the sheaf here, so, and the equivalent of a category tells you that while the map is clear, if you have the sheaf, you look at the sections, it gives you a module. The sheaf is P plus equivalent, just give you a module here. And the other direction, if you have a module here, the sheaf has a property that the section of V is equal to 1VM. When V containing N0 is in a compact open set. Okay. So step B.
No.
step B. So I give you another property of etal P plus module, that an etal has a canonical action. Of the inverse monoid. In fact, this action that if you take B in P plus, the action on M, I'll call it psi B, and is the left inverse of the action of B. This is the action of P minus 1, and this is the action of P. And the canonical action here. And we I define MC will be a representation of P and A of P plus module, B module, which is compactly induced. From this action of P for M for the P minus action. I don't define this neither, but later. And the step B tells you that this compact induced module from P minus is a space of a global section of a sheaf, which is P equivalent on N. So MCP, Z module, is equal to the sections with compact support of a sheaf, the P equivalent sheaf on N. Okay, so what is it? So what does it mean? This means that the A of P module MPC has a structure of non-degenerate degenerate, there's an A here maybe, module on the Q monoid ring N, and here you put with compact support because N is not compact. This symbol that I don't know for the Q group ring. Before it was a monoid ring, now it's a group ring. We put here P. It's defined just like that with the sips. This is what it means. So now, look at the steps C and D together. I didn't put the D. So C and D. So I introduce P1. So P1 will be G mod P, the flag variety. And instead of P1, no, G mod P, you have the an open cell, open dense cell, C, which is N W0 P P. So W0 will be an element in the Weyl group. Should have put this here. W0 in the Weyl group, which is the Weyl group, Jacques group, with a maximum length. So in for GLD, it will be the antidiagonal matrix. And the open Donsel is homeomorphic to N. By the, like this, you associate to N. So the step B is says that this is an AP module. No, it's not. Yeah. So you look at this as a on C. The action of G acts on G on P just by G. Oops, P goes to. And the action of P here coincides exactly to the action of P on N that I gave before. So this is P equivalent. So now we forget about N and zero. You are now in the flag variety. So, and what do I want to do? We want to construct so what Calmes does. He constructs a sheaf, which is G equivalent. Which extends our sheaf, our previous sheaf, P equivalent sheaf, on the cell, open cell, and the representation that the A of G module, D that we want, will be the global section of this sheaf. It comes in the natural action of G. So this is what Calmes does. So how does one do that? Well, what is the sheaf of G mod P? So this is you are looking for. So what we look for, you look for a module. Oh, I didn't say about non-degenerate. So this ring here is not a ring in the sense it has no unit. It's a ring that has no unit. I forgot to say that. But there are a lot of idempotents. And the ring, a module on this ring is non-degenerate. It means that if you have an element in the module, you can always find an idempotent that fixes it, as usual. So what we are looking now, it is a module on the Q group ring associated to the flag variety. So here you put G mod P. It is compact, so you can take this out. So the locally constant function of G mod P with value in A. And you take the product with G. The definition is the same. G with G. Now it is G mod P. And the action, and you want to see how this commute, F with G, then here, you would judge the same, G, for the right action, which is just this. Okay? And the sheaf is such that if you have a module for this group ring, Q group ring, then the section of an open compact subset of G mod P is given by this. And if you have a sheaf, you associate to it the module on this group ring given by the global section. So we are going to this ring, I will call it NAGP. Oh, this doesn't move. So So I'm going to erase it and to write it on the others. So we have our ring AC that was C which is contained in this ring. And recall this is the dark sum of it. And here, Dagson. So we are going to put some ring in the middle. And this ring in the middle is a very easy definition. It is given by the union of the V, where V is in G mod P. Compact open. It looks like a Heck algebra in some sense. And you can, so it's a ring. And the first result is that there is equivalent of a category. Between the A module that are not degenerate. So there are a lot of idempotents here, but no unit. Each step has a unit, but the whole thing doesn't have unit. And the A of GP. This one, you want them unitary. So here there is a unit because G mod P is compact. Yeah. What? If you take what?
If I take V equals G mod P in this union, don't I get the whole thing?
I am sorry. Thank you. I'm sorry. Good. So, and what, yeah.
What is the equivalent?
What is the what?
What is the equivalent?
I give it to you. So, if you take, you start from this here, you will look at the one VZ, the thin generating basis. Okay? And in the other direction, if you start with something y, here, you will take the tensor product by something that will tell you what it is, over A of y. So what is, what you define, you look at, which is just the direct sum of, now I look at my notes, I don't want to say something stupid. G so this will be left, it will be contained here and it's left module and it's the right module. An A right module. So to see that it's an A right module is useful to write A. You can write it as something like that. Sum of G in G of G by the function that are locally constant and compactly supported on G minus 1 C intersection to C.
Why
do you mean?
Y is
by tensor Z.
Is it
tensor AGP or?
Well, Z is an AGP let module, so this has a structure of AGP let module.
You start with a Y.
She's defining the Z.
Yeah.
Oh, she's defining which Z in terms of Y.
No, but this is not the same. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It is this one.
Sorry.
You see, it's nice. It's a nice one.
Okay.
It's not the same. It's not the same.
Do these functor G to start these same maps, even if there's no group action, if you just have an inclusion of a totally disconnected space inside another one?
This is algebra. Don't think. It's just automatic.
No, but can you do it purely topologically without the...
I don't know. I didn't look at that. Now it's elementary linear algebra. Okay, so when you see now C and D, sometimes to find a sheaf on the flag variety is equivalent to find a module over A. And A is equal to this. So you see now that things become complicated. Well, not finished yet. I see it's a work in progress. So we want to construct. So you have AC, which is so this. Which is contained in A, which is we had this MCP that was a module for that AC module. In fact, you are not working with this one, but you are going to replace it by erase a compact support. We define MP, which is just the sections of the P equivalent sheaf on the open cell. This is also a representation of P. And from a group theory, it's just the full induced representation from P minus to P of M. And we consider also a canonical map from this open set, which is not empty because C is dense in G mod P. So I see Colmes considered that. To P, which associate to, so this is homeomorphic to some open subset of that I'll call UG in N, because this is contained in the open cell. By U goes to U W P over P, and our map, call it beta G, so can write it like that. And it's defined by the following thing, G U N, which belongs, because you are here, it belongs to the open cell, is equal to beta W N. Why I can write this? Because the open cell is this. It's also equal to PW, which is also equal to P to NW. Well, inside of G, you have this equality. And this is congruent to P modulo N by the map going P goes ils sont homomorphiques. Voilà. To P. This is how I define that. So, you want to define an action in on MP, and I want to define an action of A. So I will take an element G and some open compact subset here that I can identify with an open compact subset here by the homeomorphism. And I want to define, if I take an element in this induced representation, I want to define the action of G by the quadratic function of V. So here I give you the formula. So V is open subset. Is open something here. You can always write, I had my my element S here that strictly contract N0, the unity plus, and you have the property that if you look at the groups that are NK, this gives you some fundamental system of open subgroup of N0 that goes to 1. So you can, when K is large enough, you can always write V as a union, disjoint union, of elements U and K, where U are, you choose some subset in V that so that it works. And you consider, for every k, you consider the following sum, which is beta at g u minus 1. And you look at the quadratic function x u of this open subset that you apply to f if you take f in MP. So it's a finite sum. And this will approximate the action of G 1V of F. You want this to be equal to the limit of this. Well, now it becomes clear that we leave the world of algebra to get to the world of analysis. To have a limit, you need to have some topology. So it's better to suppose that M is complete, that all the actions are continuous. So M P will be also complete. And you can try to find the topology are all, of course, linear topological. And you are wondering, you find you try to find f such that this converges. And then if it works, then you get what we want, an A module. And the thing is done. This is exactly what Comets does. When g is equal to gl2, you start with this Figama module. Etal Figama module, it works, and this is the story. It is exactly what Comets does, and you get exactly the same thing.
Well,
it is
a finite ring.
I didn't look at that, I am not interested. It's very new thing. You are working in a couple of minutes. Well, I will tell you, when M is compact, it works. That's an answer. It works. If you have some nice theory of integration, because you can think of this as if an integration of B applied to and some measure that depend on the action of such things here, some kind of measure. This is an integral. So when M is compact, there are no problems. But I think there are no etal modules that are compact. Or they are not interesting. They are trivial. I think it's not interesting. But the theory worked very well for compact things. And it worked very well for gel too. But it did not work very well in general like this. But it is work in progress. We are stopped here to find. So what we are trying to find? We are trying to find a good subspace. Like BD inside here, where this integral will converge for every G and every V, and then we'll define some maps. So this means an A module. Inside of MP, there should be an A module. The problem is that you can always take the zero sum module, but it's not interesting. So you want to try to find something that is not zero. But so now, then I will give you some examples, but they all come from GL2. Because what works in GL2 that doesn't work in general, in fact, what Colmes does to prove the convergence of that is using the theory of Treyi. Treyi, it means that inside of MP, you have some compact things that have nice properties. And using these nice properties, you can do that. But the theory of Treyi, I've been trying hard to generalize it, and it doesn't seem to work. And there are many reasons for that. Or maybe it's work in progress. So I don't know what time is it. I still have 10 minutes.
When you write GL2, you mean GL2 of QP?
Yes. I'll spoke only of QP here.
Yes, but yeah.
Although of what I explained now, okay, can work in more generality. But here is. So before getting to this time, this here, I can tell you that, for example, for GL2, and when this works, so you have a representation of G that is a global section of a sheaf. So there are many, many models associated to every covering of the flag variety. And there is a model that is nicer. It is what I call the W model, which is you use the fact that you can write G as a union for all elements in the Weyl group of G minus 1, C0, where C0 is the open subset containing the big cell, W. So when you take this covering of G, this open covering of G, you can get a model of the representation that we constructed. And this model is exactly the model that we see in the Colmes paper. You get a model, a W model, of this representation is contained is M W, and it is equal to the set of Z W with double W in M, and you need some relation. And you need some relation that can be deduced, that would be very easy to explain. I don't want to spend time because I have only 10 minutes. And I still have to say what is an etal module. But it won't tell you anything. And you have conditions that look at, well, maybe I had the condition. So the conditions that should be satisfied is that W prime is equal to ZW. You multiply by restriction to something that depends here. The restriction to. And there is some operator that you can deduce from this. That is. Which is an homomorphism between these things. go from this. Relation like that. And you can really explicitly find this, and it coincides exactly with the one you can read in Colmes. And can also, this, using these operators, you can define explicitly the action of G. So now I am going to speak on the last one. So you forget about all this. And you want. So you start with N0, and we take an homomorphism which is not zero in QP. And you suppose, excuse me, N in QP, and we will suppose that this and this to ZP. Then here you look at the ring O epsilon that you can consider, you can think of it as a completion of a localization. Of the Iwasawa algebra OL of ZP. So in a paper that we just published with Peter Schneider, we defined some completion of a localization of the Iwasawa algebra L of N0, which is not commutative, but can be defined. And this completion is noted N0. So we have this map. And if we start with a module here, a module, well, you can associate an OEP module just by tensor product. I call it D is equal to O epsilon. Okay. So, but now this map, you can choose a section. And you get map as a wave section. So then you have a map. So this is L, and you have a map in the other direction. In the other direction, you start with D, and you associate delta. D, and it's better to complete the thing. Complete. But if the thing is finitely generated, you don't need the completion. It will be the same. So you have functors. And just before coming, one day before coming, Zabradi. Sent to Peter Schneider a paper that Peter sent to me, where Zabradi claimed that he proved a very wonderful result, which is that these maps, this map, so L and A, define equivalence of a category. between a pseudo-compact module. With phi gamma ethyl action. So what is phi gamma ethyl action? On O epsilon, you have the action of Zp minus zero, Zp, well, one, let us see that. The action of Zp is inside of it. And on the delta L 0, you have, and this is, so this acts here, and this is isomorphic to, this embeds naturally in P plus, which acts here. And the embedding is just x. So do the thing for GL DF. Xd minus 1, xd minus 2. Okay. And if you add the center, you put the center for x. And this group, and this is equivalent for the action. Also, this group, I will call it, well, this one, yeah, I will call it D. And so phi gamma action is an action of Zp minus zero. I want to introduce the center, so I put here T star. So if you know what is the ring that is, for the O epsilon is not compact, it's pseudo-compact. So you, the, it's a complete, and you have the fundamental system of open some modules, so that the quotient is of finite length. And the finite generating module over O epsilon are pseudo-compact. And then this is very nice, because suddenly you go, you leave the world of GL2 to go to the world of G. And what do I want to say? And also, in this paper, he introduced a subring of this one, which is equal to the, it is a subring, I will not say what it is. It's a subring, ring, which contains. The image of O epsilon. And so what I got is very quickly written. And I think, well, there are mistakes, but it's normal. There are very great ideas. And I think these great ideas and my feeling, I mean, I think it works. He claims that he gets that. I didn't check, I'm not sure. But starting with D, the finger module and delta. So you get a module M, that is a T star with a T star action, which is ethyl. You go to ethyl. The problem is that you don't have an action of T plus, but you have an action of T plus. If you choose well L, you have an action of T plus here. If you choose well L, and the good choice of L is to send, for instance, this matrix. To A12. In our paper with Peter Schneider, we are looking at generic L. Here is as it is not generic at all. But then there is an action of t plus here, that is etal. The reason is that when you, you have t u t minus 1 is equal to alpha t to t1 over t2 l of u for any t. And here you don't have an action of t plus, but you can inflate the action that you have of t star. So by tensor product, you get t plus action that is etal. With trivial. With inflation, with t plus action. And we can apply our theory. And so you can construct MP. And using, for this one, using Kalman's theory, because really everything comes from D and from this, and using this ring that he introduces, Zavradi finds in different terms something inside, not zero, that has a good property. And in fact, sorry, but I want to say.